an important aside here. The reason God wants us to reject evil is not for God's benefit. Nothing we can do can hurt God. God wants us to reject evil for our own benefit, because God cares for us and loves us and wants what's best for us. All well and good, you may say, but what does any of this have to do with exorcism? It has everything to do with it. You see, we've been given several very precious gifts. The first is salvation through Jesus Christ, who died for our sins. The second is choice, or free will if that's your preference. We get to choose. We can choose for good or evil. We can choose for Christ, or we can choose a considerably darker path. An exorcism, stripped of all the Hollywood hype, is essentially a very simple rite. It is one you will probably be surprised to find you're already familiar with. It centers around a choice. To help illustrate this, I'm going to stage an exorcism. I want to do it right, so I'm going to use the official's text, right from the Vatican. It has something important to say tucked in there amid the mumbo jumbo.
Alright, we're here in front of my house. My wife Gracie often worries about my stepson Bobby. She thinks he's always possessed by evil spirits. Personally, I think it's a teenage thing. But I'm ready. I got my copy of the rite, I got my holy water, and I got my crucifix.
You're going to need a bigger cross.
Well, let's go give it a try. Oh, Bobby, I appreciate your willingness to take part in this. Why is your room always like that?
It's a teenage thing.
Oh well. Here, hold this.
What's with the big cross, Mr. John?
Well, you better ask your mom later.
What's with the water, Mr. John?
According to this, I'm supposed to start off by spraying you with holy water.
Are you sure it's holy?
Well, it's God's own recipe. Two parts hydrogen, one part oxygen. Besides, I got it in the Jordan River. Let's get started. Abre nuntiatis peccato, ut in libertate filiorum Dei vivatis.
What?
Abre nuntiatis seductionibus iniquitatis ne peccatum vobis dominator.
Huh?
Abre nuntiatis satanae qui est autor et princeps peccati.
What are you saying?
Creditis in Deum Patrem Omnipotentem, Creatorum Celi et Terrae.
In English, please?
Oh, Bobby, you reject the spiritual forces of wickedness, Satan and all his evil powers, and accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior.
Isn't that what you ask at a baptism?
Bingo. And that's the point. The exorcism is the central act of baptism. Rejecting Satan, rejecting evil, and accepting Jesus Christ. Thank you, Bobby.
Can I have my allowance now?
Gracie, it didn't work.
In all seriousness, the rejection of evil and the acceptance of Christ is the definition of an exorcism and is the human part of the baptismal service. God provides the grace and we choose to accept it. We choose the light over the darkness. All throughout the rest of the exorcism rite, it is an amplification on the same theme, rejecting evil and calling upon Christ. Satan does not like that. Whoa, you may say. What about when babies are baptized? They aren't rejecting Satan. True enough, but still an exorcism. Just as in the spooky stuff of the movies, others are speaking for someone who cannot speak for his or herself. This is the point. God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son to die for our sins. We are still sinful, but we can change. We can choose to accept the light of Christ rather than the darkness of the evil one. I guarantee you, evil cannot stand against that. So that's it. That's how I came to understand that I have a role to play as well. Christ did his part. He made the promise. I've made my promise too. I've promised to accept him. I've promised to renounce the spiritual forces of wickedness and reject the evil powers of this world. I accept the freedom and power that God gives me to resist evil and oppression in whatever forms they present themselves. I confess Jesus Christ as my Lord and Savior and put my whole trust in his grace, promising to serve him as my Lord. That doesn't mean it's always going to be easy, but it does mean that I have the tools to do so. I remember my baptism and rejoice. Praise the Lord, I saw the light.
Just like the blind man, I wandered alone. Wearies and fears I claimed for my own. Then like the blind
There's just one more rowdy friend I wanted to talk to about this.
Well, through the miracle of modern technology, I'm standing here at Yardenet on the Jordan River with Buckner Fanning. And Buckner, there's a question I've always wanted to ask you. Are you telling me that we're here at the Jordan River and the water comes up to my waist, that's not good enough?
No, won't work, no.
Well, what happens if I bring the water all the way up to the middle of my chest? That's got to be good enough.
And as big as you are, that's not enough.
Oh, man. Well, what if I get it all the way up to my neck? That's got to be good enough.
That's getting close.
This is just what I've always said. It's only the top inch or so that counts.
No, not really. It doesn't count on any of that. It all counts on the heart.
Ouch.
It all begins with a heart that has been strangely worn.
I think
that's the kind of heart burn that helps us change the world. And you may go to Luby's and get a kind of that gives you heartburn, but some Gaviscon can take care of that. But a heartburn here can come with the water of life through Jesus himself.
Thanks be to God.
Now I'm glad.